to Our Lady Immaculate and St. Etheldreda. St. Etheldreda having local significance, and one of our own Anglican churches is dedicated to her too. We've come here because today is the start of the week of prayer for Christian unity. It's the feast of the Confession of St. Peter, possibly. That's a feast which appears in many Anglican calendars, including that of the Episcopal Church of the United States and of the Scottish Episcopal Church, but not normally of the Church of England. However, it's also in the 1960 General Calendar of the Roman Catholic Church, I believe, there found as the chair of St. Peter. That's also kept in February, and with the reforms to that calendar, this duplicate feast was struck off. But I think it's a feast worth keeping because it provides a bookend for this week of prayer for Christian unity, which mirrors the conversion of St. Paul on the 25th of January, which finishes the week off. So we have St. Peter and Paul marking this week of prayer for Christian unity. St. Peter, of course, whose confession came amidst his discipleship alongside Christ, his living with Christ, discerning what God was doing through Christ, through his ministry, and through the apostles who surrounded him. St. Paul had a very different experience. Of course, his conversion was that miraculous event on the Damascus Road. And so between them, they speak to us of our faith, how God works both in these miraculous ways, in these spontaneous ways, but how God also works throughout our lives in perhaps less dramatic but sometimes more powerful ways. And so we look to both Peter and Paul for our inspiration, our example in our Christian lives, and we ask them for their prayers. We don't necessarily mark the week of prayer for Christian unity here in Newmarket with a big occasion, a big service, but more like Peter, we do ask people to pray for the life of the town here in Newmarket, pray for each other, and there are some prayer intentions which I'll link in the description below, which can be found on the Newmarket website, asking people to pray for a particular church community and a particular aspect of town life here in Newmarket each day. I would like to highlight today the work of the Anglican Centre in Rome. They are a body which works ecumenically, particularly between the Anglican and Roman Catholic churches, but also amongst many others, using Rome as a base for that work. They have offices there, they have a place of hospitality in Rome, and they're a place of study, a place of prayer, a place of pilgrimage, and a place of, as I say, ecumenical work. I'd like to highlight the Anglican Centre in Rome, partly because I'm a representative for them here in the Diocese of St. Edmundsbury and Ipswich, but also because I do believe that their work is of fundamental importance to both churches, the Church of Rome and the Anglican Church. They represent the Anglican Church globally, and the director is very often drawn from one of the many Anglican churches in communion with Canterbury across the world. I think their work is of importance because we are working for a very real, a very sacramental unity to which Christ calls us. Their work is about encouraging grassroots unity, as it were, good relationships here on a local level between Anglican and Roman Catholic churches. Their work is about learning from one another and how we construct those dialogues between one another. The latest report published by the Council for Anglican and Roman Catholic Interchurch Dialogue was about authority. It was about where decisions are made in these two churches, the Anglican Church and the Roman Catholic Church, and that highlighted some interesting differences between us which might be an impediment to unity. And it's by uncovering some of these fundamental differences that we might be able to talk about how we overcome them, how our more visible, is more practical, and ultimately, we pray, is a full sacramental unity. You may be a way off that, but that is the unity to which we are called by Christ. He prayed that we might be one, and fundamentally, we have to answer that prayer and hear that call. So I do encourage you to pray for unity. I encourage you to look at the Anglican Centre in Rome and see what they might be able to do. I say they are a place of hospitality and they can help organise pilgrimage to Rome. And in fact, we're taking a group here from Newmarket to Rome after Easter. I'm very much looking forward to that. The Anglican Centre have been instrumental in getting that going and liaising with places in Rome that we may be able to visit. And I encourage you to pray for your local churches and your local community. And I say the prayer intentions for Newmarket are linked in the description below. Father Christopher did say I could come back down tomorrow at the Vigil Mass, Saturday night vigil, so there may well be some more footage and you can meet some of the ministry team here at Our Lady Immaculate. The Lord be with you. Christ draw you to himself with all those who call upon his name and make you one in him as he and the Father are one. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you now and always. Amen.